A phase diagram is a graph of pressure versus temperature. Different phases of a substance are separated by solid lines on the graph. These solid lines are called phase boundaries. In this phase diagram of water, you can see the solid marked here, the liquid here, and the gas is here. Phase diagrams are useful because you can look at any combination of pressure and temperature and determine what phase a particular substance will be at those pressure and temperature values. So, for instance, at atmospheric pressure, which is about 101 kilopascals, we can see that all temperatures below zero gives solid water or ice. All temperatures between zero and 100 Celsius will be in the liquid phase, and all temperatures above 100 Celsius will be in the gas phase. At values of pressure and temperature that correspond to exactly on the line, it means that both the liquid and the gas phase, in this example, would exist at the same time. Values over here on the solid line between solid and liquid indicates that both ice and liquid water would be present at the same time. And on values that correspond to the solid gas phase boundary indicate that both the solid ice and water vapor will exist at the same time. The intersection of all three lines here is called the triple point. This is called the triple point because all three phases, ice, liquid water, and water vapor, can exist at the same time. You can see that the pressure and temperature that correspond with the triple point are much different than atmospheric pressures and temperatures. The pressure is 0.6 kilopascals, which is very, very low pressure, and the temperature is 0.01 degrees Celsius, which is just a very small amount above freezing. Another important point on the graph is called the critical point. Up in the right-hand corner, this is going to be the point at which at pressures and temperatures above this point, you will have supercritical fluid. So for water, that pressure is 22,000 kilopascals and the temperature is 374 degrees Celsius. So it's very high pressure, very high temperature. Supercritical fluid is going to be a phase of matter that has similar properties to gas and also to liquid. So it's going to be a gas-liquid phase that looks similar to a gas and similar to a liquid at the same time. It flows like a liquid, yet it looks like a vapor. Also, should note that two areas that are important are the normal boiling point and the normal melting point. In terms of phase diagrams, the word normal refers to the melting point at atmospheric pressure, which is about 101 kilopascals, and the normal boiling point would be the boiling point at atmospheric pressure, which is about 101 kilopascals or so. And so for this diagram, you're looking at 101 kilopascals was the normal pressure, and then that 0 degrees Celsius is the normal melting point for water. If we take a look at a phase diagram for helium, you can see it looks quite a bit different than the phase diagram for water. In this diagram, you have four phases. You have solid helium, you have liquid helium 1, liquid helium 2, and you have gaseous helium. And so these four phases exist at various combinations of temperatures and pressures, and you can see those given down here in Kelvin now instead of degrees Celsius, because helium's a gas above most everything, four or five Kelvin or so, you're going to have gaseous helium. But it's only at very, very low temperatures, like 1 or 2 Kelvin, where you can get liquid helium and even solid helium at very high pressures, as you can see here, hundreds of atmospheres or so, and very low temperatures. It's possible to freeze helium into a solid. And we can see two triple points in this graph. You can see one right here between liquid helium 1, liquid helium 2, and the gas. You see another one up here between liquid helium 1, liquid helium 2, and the solid. So how do we use a phase diagram? Well, one question we could ask is, what phase will exist at certain values of pressure and temperature? And so in this example with carbon dioxide, it says what phase will exist at 10 bar and minus 20 degrees Celsius. So to find that, all we would need to do is really just draw a line from 10 bar over to about minus 20, draw the line down to minus 20 or so, and so right there is going to be the phase, and you can see that that's clearly in the gas region. So at 10 bar and minus 20 degrees Celsius, carbon dioxide will be a gas. Another question we could ask is, what effect will pressure increases have on solid CO2, or in other words, dry ice? And so for that, all we have to do is look at the direction of the phase boundary. So here we can see that solid carbon dioxide, the phase boundary is right here between the liquid. And we can see that as we increase the pressure, the temperature at which it melts or sublimes into a gas gets greater. Okay, so that means that changes in pressure are going to result in a melting or a sublimation of the solid CO2. Another way we might be asked a question about phase diagrams is we might be asked to construct a phase diagram from some data. And in this case, you can see that we have ethanol, which has got a normal melting point of minus 117 Celsius, a normal boiling point at 78 degrees Celsius. Both of these would indicate pressures of about one atmosphere, because normal means about atmospheric pressure, so one atmosphere, 760 torr, 101,000 pascals, and so forth. Critical temperature, 243 degrees Celsius. That's going to be the temperature at which above that it's going to be a supercritical fluid. And the critical pressure, 63 atmospheres. That means above that pressure it's going to be a supercritical fluid. So can we construct a phase diagram for ethanol based on just these data? So we know that at one atmosphere, and I'm going to mark that right here, it's one atmosphere, so this is going to be pressure in atmospheres. The normal boiling point and the normal melting point are going to be present. We've got minus 117 degrees Celsius. I'm going to arbitrarily make a mark there. And we've got 78 degrees Celsius, so I'm going to arbitrarily make a mark there. So this is going to be the normal melting point and the normal boiling point. And so the thing we don't know is the triple point. And it turns out that the triple point is going to be slightly lower in temperature than the melting point, and a very, very low pressure. So the triple point is going to be somewhere down here. And so those three things are going to allow us to actually sort of connect the dots here. So if we do that, what we're going to get is we're going to get triple point here. The triple point, it's going to split off, and you're going to get that, and you're going to get this. Now, this is going to go and continue until critical temperature, which is at 243 degrees Celsius. So this is going to continue to rise. And at this point, it's going to be 243 here. And this is going to be 63 right here. So above this, you'd be looking at supercritical fluid up in here. And this is going to be the normal boiling point right there. So we can label our phases as, and this is going to continue upward like this. So we can label our phases then as solid, liquid, and gas. And then supercritical fluid above here.